देखो पासपोर्ट चेंज केला चेंज ऑफ पासपोर्ट
टू सी यू माय वाइफ
ऑफ कोर्स वेयर आर यू तू नाच मरे
इंदौर में
यो मरे मीटिंग एक भी
मैं जा रोरल मांडी
जस्ट वन मिनट पास हो एक कुछ मिनट सो सो लुइस दिस इज द कम्युनिटी ऑफ
गोल्टी
एंड व्हाट आर वी एक्सपेक्टिंग टुडे
सी वी आर गेटिंग टुगेदर ट्राइंग टू यू नो यूनिफिकेशन
Yeah,
and see, the community is all about unification.
Yeah,
it's a community. It's commune. We do everything together, and the more together we are, the more successful we are. And thanks to our ancestors that they always believed in being together,
collective working.
Yes, collective working. And now most of the people have shown great interest.
Today's agenda is.
Today's we actually meeting so that the families can come. Okay. Otherwise, generally all the gaonkars come. This time the families with the gaonkars and well-wishers, they all come together for us to have a little bit of a nice time together, have a bikaranjit jaun together, and after that continue further
yeah.
to have different kind of activities with which we can yeah. Look into all the various aspects of making the village flow with milk and honey in the way it used to be.
Bikaranjit jaun is a dying concept now.
It is in a way.
It got a bad name also.
Not really.
It's not really.
The way you look at it.
Okay.
The way you look at it. In fact, it has. It is very, very meaningful. So, Bikaranjit basically was the fact that everybody could sit together and eat together. There was nobody. Everybody is a Bikaro. Yeah. We are all Bikaris for because we all need the grace of God. We need all the good things from God. So we all.
And those people are treated as more than equal on that day, at least.
Even otherwise, they're okay. always welcome. At least in the days when we were younger,
yeah,
they were the ones who were welcome to every house. If there was an occasion, that they were the ones. It was like an extension of the goodness and well-being of everybody.
So, what's on the menu for the Bikaranjit jaun?
Oh, the Bikaranjit jaun. First of all, we have introducing the original strain of rice which we used to grow here,
which is
Kormut, and or Muno. And this rice is, it actually when you boil it, it smells of, has the aroma of exactly when the first rains come and the earth smells,
really?
It has that aroma.
Really?
The elder people, they would not eat any other rice except this. This was like their blessing from God. And that this rice is so versatile, they almost had it 4 times a day. They had it early in the morning as a kanji.
We'll talk later. And one last question, how old is this building, this structure?
This structure must have been very, very old because the kumbhis are thousands of years old. But this
few
structure
hundred, few
itself
hundred.
Was rebuilt because everybody used to sit under a tree.
Okay, I want to keep you. We'll talk later.